Welcome to Gary's SB channel again. Today I'm going to talk to you about the purposes of small talk. I'm currently getting assistance from a speech pathologist in terms of how to actually understand small talk and what the purpose of small talk actually is. And small talk is the idea of small talk. According to the speech pathologist, is to keep the conversation going from becoming too personal, to be nice to people that you don't know or trust, to fill in time when you are nervous, to allow people a little bit more time to decide what they want to talk about with you and vice versa, i.e. determine whether the person you are talking to is interested in Asperger syndrome or not. To see whether people are interested in having a more significant conversation, to gauge how a person is feeling. Great talk can talk about an upbeat topic. Don't start with sad or depressing topic. Average, most topics are not really high or low. Or low, start with a mellow topic. Don't start too high. Well, you may have found that those last points a little bit difficult to actually understand, because I have difficulty in actually with my modulation in my voice. It probably didn't emphasize the very aspects of that last bit of communication. I'm learning how to make small talk, and it's not an easy process to do, but I'm trying. I sort of find it difficult to actually wonder why people actually make small talk when really small talk doesn't seem to be about anything purposeful or meaningful. But it's interesting that when I try to follow the guidelines of small talk, my Aspie mind, my Aspie routine-driven mind, wants to try and look for some sort of routine to adopt in terms of implementing small talk. And I am going to speech pathologist once a week to learn the strategies of actually making small talk, which is not something that people on the spectrum find particularly easy. So that is just an update from me tonight, and tomorrow I start my presentation, and yeah, more updates to come later.